Well, good morning, everyone. I want to start by thanking Secretary Sebelius for her incredibly generous introduction. I could not have asked for a wiser or more supportive boss than she has been over the last 2 years. And I can assure you that she will continue to guide the high-tech programs, the HIT programs of the department with a firm and steady hand, as she has all the other diverse and important programs in the health area of the Department of Health and Human Services. I want to thank also Marty Harris and HIMSS for their warm welcome to me back to HIMSS for the second time. ONC is incredibly grateful for the support that HIMSS has provided to our office and to the high-tech agenda since its inception, since the beginning of high-tech, and to the high-tech agenda before there was a high-tech. It's hard to believe that it's been 2 years since high-tech passed and since I came to Washington. Much has changed. When I arrived 2 years ago, I was flushed with victory over the passage of the High-Tech Act. Last year, when I came to HIMSS, I was flushed with naivete over what was possible. This year, I'm just flushed. Nevertheless, there is something truly different, truly historic, and unprecedented about this HIMSS meeting and about this time in our history. For now, we can finally say, welcome to the age of meaningful use. Welcome to an era of enormous possibility, of enormous opportunity. Call it persistence of last year's naivete, but I believe we now have it in our grasp, within our collective ability to transform our healthcare system using health information in a way that would have been inconceivable just a few years ago. And I think the key to this, one key to this, is meaningful use. Meaningful use can be a transformative, multidimensional concept and power to change our 21st century healthcare system forever and for the better. Now, I think that there are three key elements to the age of meaningful use. The first, and of course the best known, is an incentive system. But there's much more. There's also a national infrastructure, which has never existed before in this country and never existed in any other country, designed to support the adoption and meaningful use of electronic health records. And third, and perhaps most vital, meaningful use is a device to bring health information to life, to support the care of patients, the health of populations, and the ever-improving capabilities of a high-performing healthcare system. It is a blueprint for what information we should be able to summon and how we should be able to use it to improve the health of patients and the health of populations. And I think it is no more or less than the tip of the spear for the creation of an ever more capable, information-driven, modern healthcare system. I'm going to say a word about each of these three elements of the age of meaningful use: the incentive system, the infrastructure, and then the blueprint for driving information-based change. The incentive program, of course, became live January 3rd. 21,300 providers have now registered their intent to become meaningful users under the Medicare and Medicaid programs. The Medicaid program has paid over $20 million to 25 providers, including physicians, hospitals, nurse practitioners, nurse midwives, in four states. In other words, meaningful use is no longer a hope or a theory. It is a working, operating program, a reality. And starting May 1st, the Medicare program will be making payments as well, payments that I think will electrify and grab the attention of providers throughout our huge healthcare system. The incentive program is not only about paying providers, it's also about transforming a marketplace. And one of the most important and rewarding elements of the incentive program has been the way it seems to be attracting innovation and entrepreneurship within the health IT community. That may indeed be its most enduring legacy. And we are aware that the timetable for stage two of meaningful use will be challenging. And we're committed to making sure, working with the field, that the next stage of meaningful use, like the first stage, will be reasonable and achievable. The national infrastructure is the second element. A year ago, the Regional Extension Center program was an idea. Now it consists of 62 programs that have enrolled 47,000 providers with the intent of helping them to become meaningful users of electronic health records. We're enrolling 6,000 providers a week or more. We're well on our way to reaching our target of supporting 100,000 providers to become meaningful users over the next several years. Recently, we added additional funding to the Regional Extension Center program, and we gave them special additional funding to support the work and the needs of critical access hospitals. They have a tall order, the Regional Extension Center programs. They're doing complicated, important work. They have a lot to learn, but they are learning and getting better every day at what they do. No country has ever tried to create an equivalent capability to support the transformation of a health information system. Training. A year ago, our training programs were just an idea. Now they consist of 84 community colleges who have enrolled 3,400 trainees who will graduate this spring to provide much needed health IT professionals to support the work that you in this audience do, the work of vendors, of providers of care, of health information exchanges. We are well on our way toward realizing our vision of training over 10,000 new health IT professionals annually. In the area of health information exchange, at the state level, a year ago, only a handful of states had health information technology experts whose job it was to make sure that health information exchange and adoption occurred within their jurisdictions. Today, every state and territory has a health IT coordinator, and 35 states have approved implementation plans for health information exchange. We are well into developing a federal-state partnership, which we think is essential to making health information exchange a reality throughout the United States. Health information exchange is a team sport. It happens locally. It needs local coaches. The federal government is far too far away from the local area to provide that kind of catalytic leadership. We believe the states are part of that solution and will be part of an ongoing federal-state partnership into the future. Standards and certification criteria. For the first time in history, this past summer, Secretary Sebelius adopted a set of standards and certification criteria to put a common platform under our diverse electronic health record and health IT community of products. Those standards and certification criteria will evolve. They will improve. We especially know that they need to be more exacting in the area of interoperability, and they will move along with the stages of meaningful use and along with the market. But they are a critical beginning, and ultimately we must make sure that they are not only standards for the U.S. market, but that they enable us to participate in international markets where health IT vendors and providers can provide service and sell their products as well. The certification process, another key element of the infrastructure. Last September, there were no ONC recognized certification bodies. Today we have six. They have certified 415 electronic health records and modules. Two-thirds of those are being produced by companies with fewer than 50 employees, a sign, I believe, of that critical element of the incentive program, the ability to stimulate innovation and to change the health IT market. Looking forward on the infrastructure side about what is needed in the near future, ONC will be concentrating on creating conditions of trust and interoperability that are essential for health information exchange. And there are two big needs in that area. One is to assure the public that privacy and security is ever present on our minds and can be provided in the context of health information exchange. My hope is that the department will take on comprehensively the privacy and security needs to assure interoperability over the next several months. We have a tiger team of our Health Information Technology Policy Committee that will report its conclusions within the next month or two, and we anxiously await those recommendations. We also envision a flexible, dynamic, and reliable system of health information exchange, one that's locally organized and managed, but operates within the federal guidelines that are necessary to assure commonality of language and commonality of standards. The federal government will offer a variety of tools to make it possible for interoperability to work. We will continue to perfect the nationwide health information network, both in the exchange variety and through the direct variety. We will continue to work on VLER and on the Connect project. These tools will be, as all of health and all interoperability and exchange will be, the product of continuing public-private partnerships with federal leadership and private execution, and constantly forming and reforming teams of consumers, vendors, providers of care, governmental representatives, and the full array of stakeholders who need to participate in a system of health information exchange to make it work. Now, the programs I've talked about up to now, the incentive program, the infrastructure programs, are pretty easy to describe. They're concrete, they're measurable, even visualizable. But I think what's most exciting about the age of meaningful use is that third element. If you believe, as I do, that within a relatively short time, most health information will be stored electronically, then meaningful use provides us a way to set expectations and goals, to create a blueprint for what information should be available, to whom and when, for what uses, in support of an improved healthcare system and improved health for Americans. Now just think about that. This is a mechanism for us collectively, as citizens, professionals, and patients, to answer the following questions, among others. What information should every health professional at a minimum have available when they see a patient? What capabilities should health professionals and institutions have to manage and use that information? For example, the ability to exchange it, the ability to use it to coordinate care, the ability to subject it to decision support. What information should be available to consumers and patients so they can participate in the management of their own healthcare? What information should professionals and institutions be able to collect and report to the public, to government, to their own professionals, to hold them accountable and to hold themselves accountable for the quality and efficiency of care that they provide? When in the history of medicine have we aspired to provide consistent, careful, collective answers to those kinds of questions? It's a huge opportunity, and to take advantage of it, the health IT community will have to rise to the challenge. The health IT community cannot operate at the margins of the healthcare system. It has to be at the vital center of the healthcare system. It has to be a partner and co-developer of the healthcare system of the future. Let me be more specific. Prior to the meaningful use process, and even since then, there has been a gap between what health information technology could do and what it was actually doing in day-to-day work. This was true in the area of quality measurement, in the area of population health measurement and management, in the area of clinical decision support. It was also true in the area of interoperability and the creation of the capability to avoid duplication of services. Meaningful use is a way of communicating fundamental requirements for information and its uses, and of harnessing information to performance improvement. And that is why the process of defining meaningful use must stay, as we hope it has been, open, collaborative, transparent, and inclusive. But it must also be constantly informed by the goals that Americans wish to see their healthcare system meet: the improvement of individual health, the improvement of population health, and the improvement of the efficiency of our healthcare system. HIT must meet the needs and demands of the users of the information that only HIT can marshal for their purposes. So these, I think, are the realities and opportunities of the meaningful use era. We are now poised, I think, as a community, to make unprecedented strides in the welfare of mankind. This is truly an historic moment. If we commit ourselves to purposeful innovation, innovation that meets needs and demands of the users of that information, we can make a huge difference for our healthcare system and for the future. It's a time of almost limitless promise. And it has been my privilege to be present with you at its inception. Thank you very much for your attention and support.